Hello, welcome back to another episode of Joe's Gym, where I use my knowledge of exercise science and strength and conditioning as well as personal training to come up with various workout routines. In today's episode, we are focusing on a bit of a theme where I talked about the benefits of caffeine to exercise as well as different alternative ways to make your favorite cafe drinks a little healthier. In today's episode, we are actually going to be doing a barista-themed workout where we're going to be using typical things that you may have seen at your favorite cafe, or if you yourself are a barista, you might recognize some of these things, as well as just kind of have a fun new way to enjoy the gym. So you might recognize a card and a drink. So you may recognize some typical movements: taking card, giving card, swiping card, you know, various things. Reaching for a drink, pulling a little lever for your steamed things, you know, just different things, even drinking. Now, if we replace those with dumbbells, you might recognize some of these movements as gym movements, actually. So we're going to be taking some of these different kind of themed exercises and putting them into a workout routine. So, here is the bulk of it. We're going to be using dumbbells today. You can use barbells, body bar, even a medicine ball if you want. However, today we're going to be working with dumbbells because you can do them both bilaterally and unilaterally. You can also do various things. If you want to make it into more of a grip strength workout, you can add two of them into one hand. And there's just a lot of different ways you can use dumbbells, so we're going to go ahead and stick with dumbbells for today. So, a lot of things that you do typically in a cafe, you're using your arms, so this is going to be mainly an arm workout. However, we're going to work out the entire body in this workout. So, first things first is some biceps, just regular bicep curls. Obviously, you're going to be using your arms, you're going to be lifting things a lot in the cafe. As a barista, you're going to be lifting things up to chest level, and even after that, you know, putting them back down. You're going to be taking things out of cabinets, bringing them up, picking them up, putting them on counters, all sorts of things. So, bicep curls are a must. So, we're actually going to be doing a superset of regular bicep curls and hammer curls. So, the main difference between bicep curls and hammer curls is how you're doing it. So as a regular bicep curl, you're going to be doing like this with your palm facing up, whereas in a hammer curl, your palm faces towards the midline of your body, towards your belly button basically. So you're going to be supersetting these. Basically, we're going to try and do 3 sets of 10 in the entire workout of everything. So you're doing 3 sets of 10 by 10 in both regular bicep curls and hammer curls. So, that's your first exercise. And then obviously taking a break is always a necessity, especially to make sure that you're not overwhelming your body, making sure you get tons of water in you during the entire time, because hydration is a must. So this is all going to be building towards kind of a massive, dude, that guy's running back and forth. He is working on it. All right, anyway, so from there, you're actually going to be moving on to a second exercise where you're basically going to be focusing on putting things on the shelves or putting them onto the highest cart or, you know, whatever, putting them on top of the fridge, etc. So these are, you know, overhead press, but you're going to be turning your shoulders, your arms, what have you, towards the camera in this instance, but in front of you, focusing on that movement of putting things onto a shelf. And then you're going to be supersetting these with raised straight arm calf raises, trying to get to the very tippy top of the shelf. So you're going to be supersetting 10 and 10 again. Now after doing both of those, your 3 sets of 10, 3 sets of 10, you're actually going to be doing one large body movement. You're going to be starting in a hammer curl position, raising it up to your chin level, and then after that you're going to be pressing over your head and then reaching up to the top. So starting right here, hammer curl position, coming up and up. So breathing is a big thing here, where you're going to be making sure to not hold your breath during this exercise, because holding your breath is bad. You really want to be focusing on breathing. So, because it is a multi-movement, it is kind of a challenge to get your breath together. So, the whole body movement again is this. And you're going to be doing these again 10 times, really making sure to get explosive movements, but not so much where you're going, you don't want to be rocking back and forth, you don't want to be putting them like way back behind you, because that's dangerous, could lead to injuries. You really want to make sure that your back is straight, you're in a full line in your body. There's going to be a little bit of a rock, but you don't want there to be like uncontrollable movements. You really want it to be controlled as much as possible. And remember, if you do want to just do arm exercises, you do not need to put the calf raise at the end. But if you want the full workout, incorporating the legs is always a good thing to do. Especially because calf raises are a simple exercise, and calves are more aerobic part of your body, where they can really put in a lot of reps, which is why you can do calf raises in much higher volume of exercise than most other things, just like wrist curls. Wrist curls you can also do way more. Like you can do 3x20 wrist curls, 3x20 calf raises, whereas most other things you'd want to do like 3x10. So just a little tip there. Alright, so for the next exercise, we're going to be focusing on the legs, because one thing that you might not know if you're not a barista is you're actually doing a lot of bending over and squatting down, spending a lot of time down here in this general area, because you're taking things from the floor or actually like 10 inches above, or 2 inches I think, above ground level, something like that. You're taking things from the bottom shelf a lot of time, and you bring them up and put them on the counters. So, or putting them away on the shelves, what have you. So these are typically like milks, kind of heavier things. So we're going to go ahead and upgrade to a medicine ball or to larger dumbbells. I like medicine balls too. But actually, I said I was going to use dumbbells, so I'm going to use dumbbells. So, for this one actually, to really simulate that milk, like gallon milk feeling, or a couple gallons of milk, fun fact, a gallon of milk is like 8.3 pounds, according to Google. So, this is about 20 pounds, this is about 2.5 jugs of milk right here, which is something that, surprisingly, you have to deal with a lot as a barista. It's randomly taking like 3 milk jugs to a fridge. Don't ask me why. So, you're going to be taking your milk jugs from the bottom and bring it over. So I'm actually going to go ahead and bring them in two hands, so there's one milk jug in each. Obviously these are dumbbells. Do not flame me in the comments for calling these milk jugs. So, start from the bottom, really get a deep squat, and come up. These are really just basic deep squat dumbbell squats. So really getting that deep, below 90 degree feel. So this right here would be 90 degrees parallel to the ground. Really getting that Z forming from here, here, to here. Getting that Z in the knees and ankles. It But because we're going deep, we're going to go below that if possible. Some people cannot get to this level. I've just always focused on legs as a pitcher and tennis and all sorts of sports. So squats were always my thing, and I can chill here for as long as I want to, basically. But really, you want to make these explosive. So really making sure to not round your back. Don't get arching your back. Make sure to try to get as straight, flat of back as possible. And in, again, 3 sets of 10. So, again, it's making sure to get that nice deep squat coming up and going right back down. And making sure to get nice explosive movements, not stopping, not making it too slow, and again, not rocking forward or back or anything like that, because again, that can lead to injury. Now, if you want, you can actually combine that last movement with that other full body movement to make one big old full body movement, like this. So, start from the ground, bicep curl, press, and tiptoes. Exercise with the legs. I mentioned just a little fun fact about milk jugs. So this next one is going to be focusing on grip. Again, having good grip strength is important because you're dealing with a lot of things where you don't want to drop things. You want to make sure you have good grip on things. Otherwise, you're dropping stuff. Stuff breaks, stuff spills. Spills are bad. Focus on grip, but again, taking 2 dumbbells, holding them in one hand. And what you're gonna do is basically just do a farmer's walk from here to the end of this gym, small gym, neighborhood gym. Maybe 10 yards. It's not too far. This is about the distance in a cafe from one end to the other. So just, if there were more dumbbells, I'd have 2 10s in this hand and 2 10s in this hand. And you're walking to the end of the cafe or gym. This is a small gym again. If you're doing this in a large gym, just have like a decent amount of space and just keep walking. So typically in a farmer's walk, you're gonna be having them kind of down by your side. But because this is kind of like a barista theme, you can be carrying them up here, down here, wherever you typically carry your milk jugs. Obviously, some people don't carry milk jugs that often. I mean, so like if you carry milk or water bottles from your car, how do you carry water bottles from your car? And this exercise, you're just going to do until eventually you cannot carry them and you start feeling them slip, and then you're just going to gently put them on the ground. Do not drop, do not let go, because again, these are kind of heavy. They're dumbbells, or a medicine ball, or a barbell, depending on what you're using. Or actual milk jugs. You could do water jugs or milk jugs for authenticity's sake. So, yeah, don't drop. No spills. That's the theme. So you're really focusing on grip strength and improving grip strength. This helps in other exercises too, being able to carry more in one hand, doing deadlifts, and being able to carry or pick up and keep the deadlift weight on is very dependent on your grip strength and how much you can grip. So this is a great exercise for that. Also, it just builds the forearm, shoulder integrity, all that good stuff, and making sure to be balanced. Like, I wasn't balanced because it was all on one side. So building that balance and making sure that you can carry things balanced, not shifting too far to one side or the other, so that can hit your back. And one of the final exercises, honestly one of my favorites, I love actually doing core. Core is one of my favorite things, and I might not be able to tell because your boy packed on some pounds before, in between jobs a while ago, where I got actually up to like 240, 250, and yeah, it was bad. And then I worked in tree service where I lost a lot of that weight. I was looking good, and then Starbucks, where I was like, Frappuccino, 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 because they were highly discounted. And yeah, I don't suggest it, because I gained about 10 pounds, and actually, from the last video that I did on alternative drinks, I actually lost a few pounds just by changing up some of the ingredients in my drinks, because I really haven't changed much else that I do physically, actively. I do actually need to start hitting the gym more often, and I'll be doing more videos like this, maybe every like once a week or once every other week. But like I said, we're doing core. So this last one is based off of being in a drive-through window. So you're supposed to be looking at the customer in the window. In the window, you're supposed to be looking at the customer. So, what you want to do is be taking drinks or food, what have you, handing them to the customer, taking the payment, putting them in the cash register. Okay? Now, obviously, you're going to be looking at the cash register, looking at the drinks when you're doing this. However, if you notice, I'm really not moving from this central position. So, you can actually mimic this by doing dumbbell abs. So we're going to be doing these dumbbell ab exercises right here, where you're going to be focusing on bringing them from one side of your core to the center of your core, pausing, and bringing them back over to the opposite side of your core. Working on your obliques, making sure you're breathing the entire time. I'm talking right now, so I'm obviously breathing. But while working out, it should be like this. So, now, I'm one of those people that you can kind of hear breathing most of the time when I'm in the gym, because I really focus on my breath. I like to really be focusing on movements, making sure that everything is correct when I'm doing it. Now, again, you're trying to keep your center intact, and one part of that is making sure your feet are pointing forward the entire time, keeping them in line with your shoulders, and to be honest, your head should also be pointing forward. This gives optimal oblique range. Now, sometimes you move the entire body, and sometimes your shoulders are doing more of the workout than your abs are. So you really want to make sure that your core is the actively engaged muscle group during this exercise. If you're doing it correctly, you're definitely going to be able to feel the burn after a couple repetitions. Alright, so that is kind of the episode right there. So the full workout, again, is you're going to be doing supersets of regular bicep curls, and hammer curls, 3 sets of 10. Then you're going to be doing shoulder press or arm press, depending on what you call it, what your background is in exercise. Again, that's going to be sets of 10. And you can also be doing the full body routines, making sure to finish out the other two by then doing either just arms solo or adding in calf raises at the end to make a full body routine, making sure not to be swinging too much when you're doing this. A little swing is natural. However, you really want to try and minimize the swing as much as possible when you're doing these exercises. Then from there, working over to legs, you got your making sure to get really deep in your squats, getting either as close to 90, at 90, or below 90 when doing this. And then at the end of the exercise, making sure, if you want, to go ahead and do a full body inversion by starting at the bottom, arm curling, pressing, and then doing calf raises at the end. And then finishing off, you can optionally do some forearm farmer's walks, making sure to combine your dumbbells, or finishing off with some abs, which is always a personal favorite, making sure to fully engage your obliques the entire time you're doing it. So that is the episode right there. If you did like it, go ahead, smash that thumbs up button. If you enjoyed the series, please subscribe. And as always, God bless, and see you soon.